Good evening, friends. I'm going to talk to you about kidney disease, which is increasing in our country in epidemiologic proportions. And why are we finding an increasing incidence and prevalence of kidney disease? According to me, these are lifestyle diseases. As you all know, now over a period of many years, we have been able to control communicable diseases, and it is the non-communicable diseases, also called as lifestyle diseases, which have taken over and which contribute significantly to morbidity and mortality. And what are these lifestyle diseases? Obesity, diabetes, and high blood pressure. So let me first tell you about diabetes and kidney disease. As you all know, there has been an increasing incidence of diabetes in our country. And with this increasing incidence of diabetes in our country, there has been an increasing incidence of kidney disease. Out of 100 patients developing chronic kidney disease all over the world, and even more importantly in our country, about 40 to 50 do so because of uncontrolled diabetes. And therefore, diabetes is now the leading cause of chronic kidney disease. What is diabetes? I'm sure you know that diabetes is a condition in which the blood sugar is high. Normally, your fasting blood sugar should be 80 milligrams per deciliter or 10% here and there, and your postprandial blood sugar should not exceed 140 milligrams per deciliter. When your sugars are high, either due to resistance to insulin or to deficiency of insulin, this persistently high blood sugars contribute to several complications in our body. They contribute to both macrovascular complications like coronary artery disease or cerebrovascular accident or peripheral vascular disease, or they contribute to microvascular diseases like retinopathy and nephropathy or diabetic kidney disease. So when the blood sugars are uncontrolled, typically after 5 to 7 years of uncontrolled blood sugars, one starts finding that the filters of the kidney become weak and protein starts leaking into the urine. In the early stages, the amount of protein lost in the urine is small, and we use the term microalbuminuria. If one can identify this at an early stage, and if one takes adequate care and takes adequate treatment, it is possible to reverse microalbuminuria. However, when the amount of protein leaking into the urine increases to a stage which can be picked up by routine dipstick, it is called as macroalbuminuria. Once this stage is reached, there is no turning back. Even if your creatinine is normal, once you have macroalbuminuria, it is usually a slowly progressive disease, and from a stage of near normal creatinine, there is a progressive rise in creatinine, and eventually entire kidney function is lost. This is called end stage kidney disease. Several studies have shown that by controlling the blood sugars well at an early stage, one can prevent diabetic nephropathy and diabetic retinopathy. This was shown by the study done in patients with type 1 diabetes mellitus in the United States, what is called as diabetes control and complication trial. And this was also shown in people with type 2 diabetes, and this was shown in the United Kingdom prospective diabetes study. Because end-stage kidney disease has limited treatment options, I request all my patients to control their blood sugars well so that they do not develop not only kidney disease but other complications of diabetes. Once end-stage kidney disease has developed, as I said, there are only two treatment options. Either one goes on lifelong dialysis or one goes for kidney transplant. If other systems of the body are good and kidney is the only major organ affected, then kidney transplant is a far superior option, and we will talk about renal replacement therapy in the form of dialysis or kidney transplant in a separate topic that I will talk about, and that is about renal replacement therapy. But I have a very important message for all those who have diabetes. One, try and prevent diabetes. How can you prevent diabetes? If you avoid eating high carbohydrate diet, which means fast foods, if you remain active, inculcate exercise in your daily routine, avoid smoking, avoid alcohol. If you do this, you will be able to prevent diabetes. And if by chance you have diabetes, you will be able to achieve a good control and prevent complications of diabetes. So, an important message for you: prevent diabetes.